This is not one of the reasons Sainte Genevieve is now a National Historical Park, but the new Sainte Genevieve Museum Learning Center is an added attraction, with a focus not on what happened here centuries ago, but what happened here tens of millions of years before that.
So entering the Hall of Giants, yes. Which is, I guess, a giant dream come true for
it's
you,
It's a dream
right?
come true. It's a place where I'm able to display my fossils, my dinosaurs, and a lot of other neat things for the public to come view.
You say your dinosaurs. You mean your dinosaurs.
My actual dinosaurs. I physically made it from scratch, all these, yes.
This all wouldn't be here if it weren't for Guy Darrough, who years ago got into the business of building dinosaur models, renting them out for displays and exhibits at parks and botanical gardens, zoos, that sort of thing.
This is your life's work.
Yes, it's taken a long time to gather this much material to be able to do this.
There's more to this place than dinosaurs. It's incorporated the old local history museum displays, but the whole town is really a museum. And the Schenck family came here from St. Louis on a day trip with more interest in Cretaceous than Creole history.
So I guess we had two kids that really loved dinosaurs. My wife found this place online. We decided to make a trip down from St. Louis to check it out.
Looks like the guys are interested in it.
They are. They're very interested. They love their dinosaurs.
My favorite is a Paralophus.
Parasaurolophus. Yeah. Yes, he's only 2 1/2. So he's 2 1/2 and he can name some of the dinosaurs.
Yeah, he can name you a bunch of dinosaurs.
Yeah, we read at least one dinosaur book every day.
Dinosaurs are people magnets. They've kept me in business forever. And I've still got my little dinosaurs that I had when I was a kid, and now they've just gotten bigger. It's just the same thing. Yeah. You know, I'm the same way.
Haven't lost interest.
No.
If there's a star of the show here, it's this, Missouri's official state dinosaur. And Guy Darrow's more than just the model maker. He's also a self-taught paleontologist who's played a pretty big part in the dinosaur story, which began with a chance discovery 80 years ago, about 50 miles from here. It was in 1942, outside the town of Marble Hill, Missouri, near Glen Allen in Bullinger County, when a boy named Ole Chronister told a state geologist that they'd found some old bones while digging on the family farm. What they thought might be cow bones turned out to be fossilized vertebrae from a dinosaur tail. But it wasn't until further investigation of the site in the 1970s that paleontologists started really putting the pieces together and identified the find as a kind of duck-billed hadrosaur, now designated Parasaurus missouriensis. When it lived, what is now North America was divided by a great sea, and most fossils today are found out west. Dinosaurs lived in the east, but the rocks and bones mostly just wore away around here. The Missouri site probably survived by falling into a big sinkhole. In the 1990s, Guy Darrough took over the site himself and just kept digging. And now when it comes to dinosaurs, Missouri is no longer flyover country.
That's what I was going to say. The cool thing is we're working with the Peale Museum and the University of Minnesota.
Yeah, we started digging there in 2017. We've been back 6 times.
Peter Makovicki has traveled the world finding fossils and frankly never expected to find such a site so close to home.
To be honest, I was floored when I saw how much material had come out. I was expecting, you know, scraps, not entire skeletons. And the dinosaur fossil record for that time period east of the Seaway is very meager. So to have a site that's producing complete skeletons and multiple complete skeletons is actually unique for the entire eastern half of the country.
Big sections of clay containing fossil remains are encased in plaster of Paris and moved to laboratories at Chicago's Field Museum. A couple of smaller pieces came to the Sainte Genevieve Museum, where you can watch the process.
And so we've been working on it for a long time. We found this guy here probably 10, 12 years ago or something like that. This right here is the shoulder blade. Going across the top here are vertebrae. These are thoracic vertebrae.
Uh-huh.
And if you look at this, like this piece here, it's called a Zygoposis, kind of a mouthful. But see the bone marrow in there?
Yeah.
But the real prize at this site was a full-sized hadrosaur skeleton. And pieces of other dinosaurs have been found.
early sort of in his work there, Guy and his team found a couple of meat-eating dinosaur teeth, a smaller one that would fit very nicely in the jaws of an animal like Velociraptor, and a slightly bigger one that probably was some kind of Tyrannosaur. So not T-Rex itself, but one of its somewhat smaller and earlier cousins. We actually don't know how far this deposit might go and just how many dinosaurs might be in there. So for me, it's very exciting.
Nothing was known, and that's what our little dinosaur site is. It's a very rare little site. It's actually an entire ancient environment preserved.
And while the dig site is not open to the public, the Sainte Genevieve Museum Learning Center is. It's a nonprofit supported by local businesses, volunteers, and admission charges. But success is not a sure thing. And yet, this is a town that is now a National Historic Park. And with the pandemic easing up, things are looking up for just about everybody in Sainte Genevieve.
That's a big deal. I hooked our cart to a good horse is all I can say, you know.
A good horse and a duck-billed dinosaur. For Living St. Louis, I'm Jim Kircher.